nenek dah koma macam sudah koma anu koma gantung sudah gantung juga di atas.
Ya, sudah okay. Naik ke atas dari tinggal timur rantanya.
Ini kasih rantai. Di belakang ada label ada.
Ada label di
belakang. Okay. Juga. Senam kah sama tuh yang di belakang sama yang itu label yang ya. Di belakang and the nama.
Ya memang sama.
Kasih jangan kasih dia goyang, kasih pegang dulu dia, pegang dulu dia. Jangan kena kok punya gelap nanti itu lukisan. Ini tahun berapa nih, Nin? Di sini, di belakang? Di belakang? Oh. Oh. Coba ya nampak itu kan di belakang juga, Nin? Kasih anu, Nin, kasih rata lagi dia, kok pegang dia. Oh, okay. Dan supaya dia tidak goyang, tunggu dulu. Saya mau tinggal di bawah, tinggal atas. Oke. Okay. Oke, okay. And then in label, oke okay, kan? Ini. Kasih rata dia sedikit kalau kamu kasih. Ah, bukan dia, kau pegang lah. Kasih pegang lagi ini, jangan dia goyang. Oke, okay. Yang ini lagi, kita. Oke. Okay. Ini oke okay, sudah kan? Oke, okay, ini. Art is necessary for everyone in a way. Something that people think is the least important. I can understand why that is, because people think art is just something that you paint and you put on the wall. But actually, it has a lot more importance in art that people don't really are aware of. So if you take art out of our system, then I think we will just die as a species, because it will just break your, you know, your soul will have nothing to get excited by. Art is just like music.
Yeah, that's a very important question, I think. This is what I have been telling all the while. Now, unfortunately, many I still have this attitude that I want to get it for free and I want to get it cheap. That is the worst attitude to support our artists. You see, to support our artists, we must encourage our own people to buy their work. Buy it as a present for others. Buy it to decorate your house. Trust me, they are as beautiful as what you buy from outside. Look at the paintings in my room. They were done by local artists. And I would say, and a lot of people who have come into my room have said, so they are of international class. So to those outside there, Sabahans, be proud of our own artists.
My name is Jennifer Lingi, and I'm the director of the Sabah Art Gallery. So I studied architecture and I worked as an architect in London, in Brunei, and then I came back to Sabah. So I got more involved with the Sabah Art Gallery at the time because I was doing research on traditional craft.
Hi, my name's Ilan. I'm from Kota Kinabalu, Sabah, and I've spent the last approximately 25 years in KL. And then recently, 2016, 2017, I moved back home to Kota Kinabalu.
Yeah, my name is Christiane Gunting. Originally, I'm from West Malaysia, but I've been in Sabah almost 30 years now. My career as an artist actually began in 1981. I've been in art for a long time now, almost 40 years, is it? If I'm not mistaken, yeah. As an artist, using Sabah as my base, I have been taking part in all the local art exhibitions.
So I love it that I'm surrounded by art all the time. And the best part of my job is I get to work with artists. Art and artists. And I think it's what's wonderful about working with artists, even though artists are really hard people to work with, because they are very passionate about this or very sensitive, right? And sometimes a bit off. I'm a bit off too. So you really have to know how to talk to them. And I think that's a nice... what I like about working with artists is very pure. It's straight from their heart. They tell you why they're doing the painting. Sometimes they tell you things that are so private to them. You know, they tell you, like, I went through depression. And then through that depression, because this happened, that I painted this. And you can see it in their painting. So it's a privilege, actually, to be able to, you know, when they tell me about it. I really feel I'm very privileged.
My artwork is really an output of my own discoveries and curiosities as I try and find reasons and meanings and better understanding. A lot to do with social political landscape in Malaysia, but more specifically the Southeast Asia region. So a lot of my curiosity is driven by social political conditions and landscapes. Politics to me means the organization of society, of how we organize ourselves. And I'm interested in the power structures within society, and also different kinds of knowledges, different ways that we keep knowledge or transmit knowledge. So all of this feeds what I do as an artist, as I try and unpack it. I often talk about my artwork as kind of a byproduct of my personal learning. It's a process of exposing my learning, and then hopefully other people are interested in taking part in a conversation. So even if somebody disagrees, that's part of the conversation.
So about 10 years later, I came back again to Sabah, but this time to stay. I like Sabah. So as an artist, I feel that after living in Sabah and assimilating the way people live here, food, the culture, the dances, the colour, the festivals, I've actually started portraying all this into my paintings as well, and I share it with the outside world through my art.
Art is another dimension of that cultural diversity. Sabah artists have done their part, they've showcased their product to the rest of the world, and we are Sabahans are being recognized for their work. I think the impact that Sabah artists have done to this region, there's practically no limit to it.
If you look at the art is a visual documentation of the history of any country, whichever country the artist is from. If you want to learn history, most of it is always written, right? But it's so boring. So a lot of people will, unless you really like going through historical books or documents, then you know a little bit. But through art, you can see immediately, you see something and you go, oh, they used to have bamboo houses. 50 years, 100 years from now, nobody will know people live in bamboo houses. But it's already captured in our painting, right? Or Kampung Air, or Tamu. 100 years from now, there will not be any Tamu. But people will see the painting and they go, ah. So in a way, art is starting point of creativity.
Creativity is required in everything that we're doing. Whether you're a doctor, you're an accountant, you're a lawyer,
you need creativity, because in order for you, even in your business, you need to be creative. But if you don't have art as a form of creative stimulus, you know, for you to think, everything that we do is always very sort of one direction only, right? You're told something, you follow that. That's not going to help us.
I encounter very creative people almost on a daily basis. People who have so much to say, who have incredible passion about whatever it is that they're obsessed by. And I just see this creative thinking, this criticality amongst communities in Sabah all over the place. I do think that Sabah Art Gallery is intrinsic to the Sabah creative art landscape. And it always has been. It's one of the earliest art galleries in Malaysia. And it's a home base, if you like.
I became a minister of tourism, culture and environment in 2007, if I'm mistaken. Of course, at that time, Dato' Yaman was the curator of the art gallery. First and foremost, after many years, we still didn't have a gallery. And secondly, Dato' Yaman was such a passionate artist, and I thoroughly believe that what he wanted deserves to be deserve serious considerations. And for that reason, I ensure that he sees the fruit of his labor, his request. We ministry secure a budget of 16 million to construct a purpose-built art gallery in Sabah. And that was the beginning.
Sabah Art Gallery is our depository of Sabah arts, first under Dato' Yaman and now under Jennifer Lingi. And it's played a really important, stable and constant role in collecting Sabah art with a specific vision that was established by Dato' Yaman, which is a particular look and type of art to establish that Sabah identity, which I understand within its context.
Without Dato' Yaman, I don't think there would be an art gallery, maybe. Nor will the development of art in Sabah be this good. Because I think what he has done is he fought very hard. He had been thinking about art. I think his whole life is about art. And he had been talking to politicians and writing letters. We found a letter that he wrote to the Minister of Culture, Youth and Sports, I think at the time, asking for him to start an art gallery. And I think Dato' Yaman was always pestering any like Dato' Haris, Tun Fat Stevens, and the minister at the time to set up an art gallery. So that was in 1976, but Dato' Yaman had been forming art society since 1959, I think. Finally, in 1984, Sabah Art Gallery was officially formed. But it was parked under the Ministry of Youth, Culture and Sports at the time, because it was the fastest way for them to form an agency. So the gallery now is about 36 years old.
And at that time, the Sabah Art Gallery was still at the old museum site.
Then when I came to Sabah first in 1985, I had one of my solo shows here at the Sabah Art Gallery, which was then at the museum.
When the project was approved by the ministry, Dato' Yaman worked with the architect at the time, come up with the design of the building. After seeing a few, I think he had about five or six, he was still not happy with it. I was the curator of the gallery at the time, so I didn't, because there was an official architect, so I didn't initially got directly involved because we had already appointed an architect. But after a while, I could feel he was so frustrated. So what I did was I said, what do you want, Dato? So what would you like? He said, I don't want a long building. I don't want an, because he said people get tired if it's a long, big building. So I knew in my head it has to be sort of like a circular or like a small building. He said he wanted people to be able to not get tired. So I knew there must be like a central circulation. So it's easier, right? Rather than you walk from one end to another.